April 29th is National Shrimp Scampi Day.
Oh!
You had me at shrimp. Today on Cooking with Vinny, a variation of that classic dish.
From an undisclosed location in the mountains of Northeast Georgia, this is Cooking with Vinny.
Shrimp scampi is basically shrimp in a garlic and lemon butter sauce. But you can't get fresh shrimp here in the mountains of Northeast Georgia. And I've gotten too many packages of frozen shrimp that had no taste whatsoever. So here is the bait and switch. I'm going to use Langostinos. Why, you ask? Because Costco had this big 2-pound bag of cleaned and cooked Langostino. Langostinos is one of them crustaceans that get mixed up with so many other crustaceans. Now pay attention or fast forward, because here is where it gets technical. Langostino is Spanish for little lobster, but it's not actually lobster. Langosta is the Spanish word for lobster, the real lobster. Here in the U.S. of A., Langostino is an alternative name for the squat lobster. And who has ever heard of the squat lobster, which is also not a lobster? Langustes is Spanish for the spiny lobster or the Caribbean lobster. And langostines are your Norway lobster, sometimes called, are you ready for this? Scampi. All of this for shrimp scampi without the shrimp. The sauce for scampi is basically a garlic and lemon flavored beurre blanc, or white butter. To make a beurre blanc, you reduce white wine or vermouth, or even white vinegar with shallots until the liquid is almost completely gone. Then you take it off the heat and you mix in butter one pat at a time. You're creating an emulsion, an intensely flavored butter sauce. Oh! But a scampi sauce doesn't have to be as rich or thick as a beurre blanc. Since this sauce is going to be thinner than the traditional, I am going to be mixing equal parts of white wine and chicken stock. The chicken stock keeps the richness without adding any extra butter. Here's what you're going to need. A pound and a half of clean shrimp or the langostinos, along with a half a cup of wine, a half a cup of chicken stock, juice from one lemon, zest from the lemon, and about a third a cup of chopped parsley and 1 teaspoon of kosher salt. You're going to pepper to taste. I sweat some shallots and garlic in some olive oil. Then add the wine or vermouth along with the chicken stock and the juice from one lemon. Now I zested the lemon because, well, it was there. And if you decide you want to use some lemon zest, you'll have it. Reduce the liquid by about 2/3 and then turn off the heat. Start to add the butter. I was getting used to this new induction burner, and I thought I was turning the burner off. Instead, I turned it down. See, if the heat is too hot, you're just going to simply melt the butter. Now, there is nothing wrong with melted butter on shrimp.
Whoa, it's good.
Add the langostinos or the shrimp to the sauce and just cook long enough to heat through. If you're using raw shrimp, you're going to cook the shrimp in the sauce. This shouldn't take more than about 3 to 5 minutes, depending on the size of the shrimp. You want to cook it just until it loses its translucency. You want it to be cooked through. Translucency. Taste the sauce and adjust for salt and pepper. Add some of the chopped parsley and some of the lemon zest. Toss everything together and serve over rice or pasta, and sprinkle a little more chopped parsley on the top. Boom! There you have it. Shrimp scampi made with langostinos. Ciao from that one.